Yo, my name is Flame, and welcome to another episode of Blockbuster Tips. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make specular textures for your Blockbuster models and texture packs. However, I will not be covering normal maps since its process is quite difficult for me to understand. Special thanks to Tian Tou, Michael Creeper from Bilibili Blockbuster community, and people from Shader Labs for helping me understanding specular textures. For this tutorial, you must use Optifine and any shaders that support specular maps, and this model only works on models that has a texture file or your own texture pack. To put specular maps in a very simple term, it is a layer that can make textures reflective or glow by changing red, green, blue, or alpha channels. Meanwhile, normal maps is a layer that make your textures look 3D even on a completely flat surface. Here is one of the examples provided by Michael Creeper featuring specular textures on Blockbuster models. To keep things simple, I will not be explaining porosity and subsurface scattering. A documentation of lab PBR will be provided in the descriptions. Smoothness changes how smooth your texture looks. For both lab PBR and Suse PBR, it is represented by the color red. Metalness changes your texture's reflectiveness. This effect will be much visible with smoothness. For both lab PBR and Suse PBR, it is represented by the color green. Emissiveness changes how bright your textures glow. For lab PBR, it is represented by alpha channel, aka opacity. For Suse PBR, it is represented by the color blue, and only applied on some shaders like VSL or complementary shaders. All of them follow the same format here. The higher the respective values are, the effects will be more visible. In most cases, you won't need to use porosity or subsurface scattering at all. Now let's move on to how to make the specular maps. First, select a skin and make a duplicate of it. Rename it with the same name as your original skin, but with an underscore S at the back of the file name. This file will be our specular map. Open the file with an image editing app. For my case, I will be using Aseprite. Highlight the part you want to apply specular on. Adjust your color based on the effects you want. I will be doing emissiveness using Suse PBR format. Make sure the specular map is saved in the same folder as your original texture. This method also applies to making your own texture pack. Now you might ask this:
why is my texture not glowing or reflecting? Do I need to use a multi skin for this?
In your shader selection menu, you should first check whether specular maps are enabled. And as I've mentioned before, you must use shaders that support specular maps like VSL, Complementary, Suse PTGI, etc. You can find more of them in the Lab PBR Supported Shader Packs list. In shaders like BSL for example, try finding a setting for materials and enable things like reflection, and select the format you prefer here if available. It is highly recommended to disable some settings like parallax or culture mapping, as it messes up with some Blockbuster models as shown here. To answer whether you need multi-skin or not, the answer will be no. Just select your skin normally and make sure to pick the one without an underscore S. And that is it for the tutorial. Hopefully you understand how to make specular textures for both Blockbuster models and custom texture pack and apply them in game. As to achieving the effects you wanted, just play around with the color and alpha channels yourself. Thanks for watching and goodbye.